मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट इंटरप्ट्स। फॉर एग्जांपल, इंटरप्ट, व्हाट डू फर्स्ट लेट्स सी व्हाट डू मीन बाय इंटरप्ट। इंटरप्ट इज अ वर्ड व्हिच वी यूज इन अवर एवरीडे रूटीन, लाइक डोंट इंटरप्ट। सो basically interrupt means in between. If we do something in between of another work, then it called as interrupts. Interrupts can be anything. Okay, just like take an example, when two persons are talking about something serious and third person comes and say something, maybe it's important, maybe not, but don't interrupt. Interrupt basically the things which pause something and execute itself. Okay, that is called as interrupt. Any type of operations you can take is an interrupt. So when it happens, when a program enters a wait loop in which it repeatedly tests the device status, and at that point of time the processor is not performing any type of useful computations, and there are many situations where other tasks can be performed while waiting for an IO device to become ready. That means we are printing something, and printing is continuing in the printer, but we are waiting, the CPU is waiting for any type of other work, it is waiting for IO devices to become ready. That means printer to be free. Okay, and at the time of printing the processor is not performing any useful computation, because printing is the work of a printer, not the processor. And processor's work is once it given the task into the printer, its task is completed. And to allow this happen, we can arrange for the IO devices to alert the processor when it becomes ready. It can so by sending hardware signal call and interrupt request to the processor. Okay, so if we want to do something into the processor, and if we want to do something in the processor, that means we want to use the processor, or we have some task to processing, then we have to send a hardware signal that is called as interrupt request to the processor. Okay, let's take an example that if we press the key shift let continuously, then it will display a message. Okay, and how it will happen? For example, we are reading, or I am reading this document, Word document, but at a time I am pressing the key. Okay, and when I am reading this document, the processor is not doing any type of work. Okay, it just displayed the document on the monitor. It loaded into the monitor, but it's idle. And that point of time when I am pressing the shift key, that means it's sending the request that I am interrupting something. Something is coming. Some inputs are coming from the input devices, and we have to display this message. So this can be called as an interrupt also. Okay, or let I insert and pen drive into the system when I am reading this document, so that after some time it will display a message that your hardware is ready to use, or some pop up screens that open the folder, view this folder, okay, or scanning. So these type of messages, these type of operations, we can call it as an interrupt. Okay, so we have to first send an interrupt request to the processor. And since the processor is no longer required to continuously pull the status of IO devices, it can use the waiting period to perform other useful tasks. Okay, that means I am downloading something in the Google Chrome or from the browser. So at that point of time, when I am downloading, at that point of time I can also listen some music. Okay, and when downloading, processor is not doing any type of work. After downloading, it will save in the memory or it will display. That time processor work will start. But during the downloading, the processor is idle, so we have to use this waiting period, this time of idle period, by doing some useful works. Let I am downloading something from the browser, and at a time I am taking the classes. It's possible.